do it all night. She going hard, right? She loves spotlight. She make that thing go. Drip, drop, drip, 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 drop, drip, drop. I do my drip, drip, drop, drip, 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 drop, drip, drop, drip, 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 drop. I know you got that bomb, shorty, can I get it?
Can I get it?
Something on my mind, girl, I know you ready. I can't stop eyeing you, loving the way you move. Got me obsessing, the sex undeniable. Don't let go. Yo, you wanna get it when you on that pole? Or you wanna get it, but you're scared to admit it, cause you're living for the minute when you on that flow. Making dough, and look at the way you dance.
Doing it for the band.
You got a lot of fans, make me wanna wash my hands. She do it all night. Let me put you in a vitty. Maybe later on say hello kitty. Sorry if I come off too strong, but this your song. And if you come with me, you can pop on daddy. Like my middle name is Diddy. What you wanna do, girl? Can I guess it? You're my new girl, so let me test it. Let me get that thing. We can play first string. Come and sit on my bitch. Let me press it. You so excited, delighted to hear. I like it. The diamonds in my watch, you know they be shining. She do it all night. She going hard, right?
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Honey Drip Radio. You have me, Tigress, and Miss Panther in the building. How are you tonight?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm not too bad.
That's good. That's good to be here.
Yes, it is. Another HDR Live Open Mic. Yes, HDR Live Open Mic tonight. We're I think we have our other host. They will be calling in shortly. I want to thank everybody for tuning in with us. We have this show every Tuesday at 8 p.m. And Miss Panther Show, you know the drill.
Yeah, I know. My show is called Beast Queen Sanctuary of the Mind. And it's on, Thursday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And it's an open mic as well. And I'm really looking for some new talent to come through. But I welcome all talent. We welcome all talent on both shows.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, I found a couple artists that said they would come through for interviews. So we'll see how that goes. But that's about it.
Okay. And I've connected with a few people as well. So we do, our next couple shows, we do have some guests lined up. And especially next Tuesday, I just confirmed it with, Clifford Ryan, Jihad. You know, he goes by a few different names. He's doing this, the OGs Against Violence. You know, I don't know if you've seen his picture. You know, he got everybody holding up the sign with, I think you probably seen mine. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm so like, that's my friend.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so he's been doing that, and I'm confirmed it. So next week he's going to be on, and we're going to try to do something. I'm going to try to get it all set up by next, do something special for him, because he's really been going around, literally walking around Syracuse here, holding up the sign, taking pictures with people. You know what I mean? That takes a lot of heart to do that. So he's going to be with us next week. And the following week, we do have another guest that will be coming on, an artist. And I think I'm working on someone for the following week as well. So we back on our grind, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I do have a few people I'm going to connect with them to connect with you for your show as well. So, you know, if you're a new upcoming artist and you're looking for an interview just for like a little more exposure, you know, and to just connect with some new people, you know, contact us on either, you can connect with me or Panther on Facebook. We also have our Honey Drip radio page. You can contact us on there, or if you know someone that's an artist, that's what we're here for. And something else. I haven't worked on our issue yet for our anniversary issue, but it will be coming out. It's going to be just a brief issue because now we're into our third year for word of mouth, and we're headed into our third year. Can you believe it's September already today? So we are old. We 3 months away from our 3 year anniversary for Honey Drip Radio. So I'm excited about that too. I'm like, wow, we just aging with this.
We sure are.
Yes. Yes. We are going into our third year. So we gotta set something up for that as well, besides doing a show.
We gotta do a meet and greet or something.
We need to. We got Mr. Beast King in the building now.
We were 3 years.
What?
Put your tongue back in your mouth.
We're not going to talk about that on the radio.
You drinking the mic? People gotta talk on that. You know what I'm saying?
I bring my own mic. I bring my own mic to the own stage because it's pointless. Because I can do things like that.
Yeah, imaginary mic you put in your pocket.
No, I got a magic mic. It ain't in no pocket. No, that's another show, girl. That's what I'm playing. You don't know.
Oh, wow. So, Mr. Beast King, before we go any further, congratulations to you, because you was working that mic in Chicago. I saw the video.
Oh, thank you. I've humbled. It was a wonderful a way beyond wonderful experience. I had to. I had to represent for the whole house. I had to go Jumanji.
Yes, you
they
did.
And it was coming off. They didn't know I could go that fast. They was like, God poor, the child was so excited. My buddy.
Oh, Tyrion.
Yeah. She killed it. I don't know
Charles
if they recorded.
Yeah.
I don't know if she got recorded, but she killed it.
Charles called me 12 o'clock in the morning with her on the phone, asked me, do I know who she is? I'm like, it's 12 o'clock in the morning. I don't know who I am.
Yeah, because she asked. No, because at first, she was like, let's call April. I said, nah. I was like, what about Panther? I said, yeah, she probably won't.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. And yeah, you was going in on that. I'm like, I know everybody probably like, is he really just freestyling all this? Because you had, like, I don't know if I could do that. I have to have my phone, iPad, something, reading something. I'm not ready for that yet. But you did it. You mastered it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm so humble. Yeah, no, I couldn't. It would have took away from me.
Mm-hmm.
It would have took away from, like, everything if I would have had, like, a paper or anything looking at.
Okay.
He had everything written on his hand. He's full of crap.
Never. That is not true because it's on my hands. Spirit fingers.
Did I see a pole in the back of that video? Or no, maybe. I'm just
kidding. No. That, no, it was a mic stand.
Mm-hmm. You did swing around it once, so. Or maybe I was just seeing things. I don't know.
Mm-mm. Me swinging around a pole at that moment, that would have been like giving a whale a Tic Tac. That wouldn't work.
No, but that was so great to see y'all together doing that. Oh, how many poets was there all together?
Oh, my goodness. It was, I had a roll call. It was Brother O was there. Word Warrior was there. Elliot was there. Poet Carrie B was there. Queen the Poetess was there. Oxygen was there. Lydia Born Right was there. It was a poor for Chicago named Restore. Brother Amir was there. Hood Rays was there. Another poet named Geronimo Speaks. Another poet named Kel. Another poet named, it was like a lot of poets. And like four radio networks was all there at the same time because Kingdom Inc. was there. DSR was there. Epiphany was there. And we was there.
Wow. Okay. Well, since you have... Oh, where did Panther go? She just disappeared.
She's running.
All right. Well, let's go to a quick music break, and then I want you to open us up since you're so... arrhythmic.
Oh, I'm ready.
All right. Play a quick song and we'll be right back.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure.
The heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, no. Now the war is not over, victory isn't won, but we'll fight on to the finish, and then when it's all done, we'll cry glory, oh glory, oh.
Selma is now for every man, woman, and child. Even Jesus got his crown in front of a crowd. They march with the torch, we gon' run with it now. Never look back, we done gone hundreds of miles. From dark roads, heroes, to become a hero. Facing the League of Justice, his power was the people. Enemy is lethal, a king became regal. Saw the face of Jim Crow under a bald ego. No one can win a war individually. It takes the wisdom of the elders and young people's energy. Welcome to the story we call victory. The coming of the Lord, my eyes have seen the glory.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, glory,
glory,
oh,
glory. All right, we are back. Welcome back to HDR Live. We have Mr. Beast King in the building, Miss Panther, and me, Miss Tigress. And we are about to get this started. You back with us, Panther?
Yeah, I'm back. I don't know what happened.
She will, I'll tell y'all later.
Okay. My business. I hit the wrong button.
All right, well, Mr. Beast King is going to open us up tonight. And for those who are listening, if you want to get in a call queue, just hit *6. And Beast King, the mic is yours.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I would like to invite you. I invite you to these festivities that are here before you right now. Welcome to the funeral. They always told me that you got to express yourself to the point of no return. And there were so many different lessons and pathways I had to learn. So this is my crucifixion. I'm laying all of my sins bare, and I know that you don't care, but I know I want my soul to be released, so everything else that is in me that is not like God needs to be cooked medium rare. Welcome to my crucifixion. All of the lies and all of the lustful and all of the pride and all of the things that was in my mind that was similar to homicide, I'm laying it all bare. They told me that you have to hold up your own cross, so I'm laying my cross proudly. I'm putting my love on display so I can express it even more loudly, see? I walked through the valley of death so many different times. It was like Michael Jackson moonwalking. I had to watch my own steps. I seen so many different things that I thought was nightmares, but they were my daymares that turned into nightmares, so I had to unload my dreams, see? I used to be an evil person. The mind that was constantly working about how I could disassemble and reassemble guns and shells to start squirting. See, this is the adult version. I used to be A person that was so mad and sadistic and sick, and I was waiting for, I wish a nigga would, to talk that shit, for me to bust them up in their lip, hit them with a bat, razor blades, guns, gaps, clips. I want to do all of that type of gangsterous type shit. But you see, I just had an issue with anger, and the anger had an issue with me, because the anger was like a rapture, but it was always kind of capture me. I never thought about happily ever afters. I was always closing the chapter, see? But until the master started talking to me, the master told me to sit down and chill and be real, and the master started walking with me. See, I opened up the Bible, but even though it was changed and rearranged 1,146 different times, my father showed me how to conjugate my verbs and drop down so many different lines. He was like, you need to listen more and talk less. You let this world take you out and have you filled with so much stress, and I'm the one that ordained you to be the best. So don't be like Usher, but this is your time to confess. So here, I had to express my crucifixion. Everything that I did to everybody that I ever hurt, I apologize. But I had to be a man about it, so now I had to realize that every word that comes from my mouth, I have to emphasize, because so many different people try to spit truth, but it's riddled and wrapped up like fruit roll-ups with lies. So in my crucifixion, I want it to be so beautiful. I want everybody to wear black and get dressed up for my flesh funeral. And when I lay my head down for my final resting place, let my pen show the amazing grace and look into my eyes to see all the adversities that I had to face. But now that I have a new life, it was no longer an open and shut case. Let my crucifixion be an example for you. Because sometimes you got to crucify the lies and everything that was in your life that was not supposed to be in you for you to be free. I ain't trying to tell you to be like me. I just want these words to set you free and eat.
That was hot. I enjoyed that. That was kind of Heaven's Blade-ish, you know. You pulled them out a little bit, but I enjoyed that.
Thank you. I'm trying to tell you, I'm a little bit different since I came back for the show.
Wow. Yeah, well, I can imagine what you're going to start pulling out with now. I'm surprised you ain't pulled no beat out on stage.
They weren't ready for that. They were not prepared for that at that moment. But it was in my mind to do it. It was in my mind to do it. If I would have had one of y'all with one of them iPhones or one of them high-grade phones, I would have pulled the beat out.
Mm-hmm.
And I would have snapped. But I did what I had to do. I'm hyped now. Oh, yeah, y'all started something now. Ooh,
oh, boy. All right, let's get this moving. We do have a few listeners in queue. If you want to get in the call queue, hit *6 and we'll get you on. Ms. Panther, are you ready to do a piece?
Sure. What do you want to hear? Do you want to hear something with a little bit of spunk, or do you want to hear mushy?
Let's get some spunk. Let's get some spunk.
I knew it. It was like we were doing like a telepathy thing, because I was about to say spunk. I was about to say it. And then you were already, we did this X-Men thing, and then you said it, and I'm about to be like, spunk, spunk, spunk.
Yeah, mushy is good, too. Tigress is just addicted. She needs to go to rehab. That's sad.
I love those funky pieces. I love funky songs. They just get me. You should hear my music mix when I go to the gym. My daughter's like, what's wrong with you? What? Songs. Like Eminem. I love Eminem. You wouldn't know it, but I love Eminem. You get to be hype. Like, yes.
Mm-hmm. I love Eminem, too.
Yeah. See? Okay.
bring that spunk.
I actually made up my own quote and wrote a poem to it. The quote is, "The worst thing you can do is break a woman's stride and treat her as if it, blah, 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 and treat her as if she's irrelevant. I keep on hearing, don't push me away. I know what I want, and it's you. I awake to your voice, and as I lay my head to fall asleep, we shared an eternity within mere seconds, weaving in between possibilities. No one has been this close to my spirit for quite some time. Now I fully understand you're her man, and I'm just that comfort zone you've been seeking. Yet you fucked up this time and dealt love's hand to a thoroughbred. Now time is misleading. I'm losing my grip. Don't fret, for I knew what it was from point A to Z. Temporary sexual pretenses. I went against the grain and got caught up in feelings that mean nothing. Not the fucking thing. Shit, you treat me like fool's gold. And the game I fell for, very old. Blindly, I just sat and waited, hoping to be that one to revive your soul. But what's done is done. We had our fun. This remission is only affecting me. I don't do competition, see? I've been exactly where you are, and believe me, wondering why her and not me. How could you love a person at your own convenience, yet you claim you'll never forget we? How could you play with my broken heart like you weren't the person whom helped me win? And act like we just met, 26 years gone hard, and all you can offer my starving spirit is your dick in hand, claiming I'm your world, yet I barely exist. I cried many nights to the thoughts of him, and I see the same reflection staring back at me within a different host's body. However, now I wish you luck and many blessings. You don't need me for second guessing. The both of you showed me a valuable lesson. This love shit's for everybody but me. Although still, I wish you would have warned me that your plans were to give me false hopes once again. Fuck it, I'm a big girl, and I've learned my lesson. Panther, Team Hungry, and Eat."
Yes, 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 yes. That's all I can say. Yes. I love that.
Thank you, sis.
I'm excited, though. No.
That's a darn shame.
Oh, I love that.
I like the spunkier pieces, too, so I'm just as guilty.
I think you may be seeing pass
that's
out.
Yeah, funky. I don't never get. I don't pass out. I pass up. That was the ish. That was the ish. Pantherillo. You rolled that track up like a cigarillo. You was like, roll it, freaking smink.
What you know about a cigarillo?
Look here.
Don't make me repeat my God.
I wasn't always a good boy. I was just a bad boy. This is a bad boy back in the day, you know. Back in the day when you were still wearing a bobby tail, bobby socks, you know. You still wearing a bobby socks, you know. We still had the white black shoes on with them dresses with the all guy outside.
You act like I'm 12 years old.
I'm just saying. Those couple years, man, it's a lot.
Okay, you burped and peed and walked before me. That's it.
No, I burped, I peed, I walked before you. I drunk, I smoked, I did some things before you. Some things before you. You know, because I did some pain for you. Back in the day, you wouldn't have been ready for this. Your hair would have been like red, blue, green. You would have like a rainbow, like somebody just put Skittles in your head, girl. You don't even know. Yeah, I like Eminem too, plain or peanut. You don't even know.
You like peanut Eminem,
really? Oh, boy.
He confessed that on air. You heard that, sis. He likes peanut Eminem.
Mm-hmm.
I said candy. That's candy. For all the ones whose minds are in the gutter, Panther, I guess that's why I said plain and peanut Eminem. Let me slow it down. Slow it down, peanut. And it's in a bag that's a yellow, and it's candy.
Mm-hmm. We both are. We hear you, bro. We hear you. We hear you.
I mean, I know you. I mean, I know you on her side. It's okay. It's okay. I got never love for you. Regardless, you can be on her side. I ain't going to talk about how she like them paydays in that Fifth Avenue when she was saying she want a symphony, but she really want that 100 grand. And all that to be said, she just likes stuff with a lot of nuts in it. But I ain't going to say nothing about that. That's none of my business. It's my thing.
You done made her call drop again. What you do?
That's what I'm going to use a toast.
You made her disappear. She just, her line just dropped. Pampish.
I got knocked off again.
I asked him what he do to you. Your call just dropped.
I know.
So regardless, you do.
All right. We do have another caller. Let's get this young lady on the line, 901. Welcome.
Hey, family. How y'all doing?
Hey, sis. How are you?
I'm doing okay.
Hey.
What's going on? What's going on?
You ever come on that honey love? Have all that honey love. Yeah, Scorpio in the building.
I see y'all live in full effect. That was a great piece you did, Panther.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's incredible. With that ugly cry.
What are we going to do with him?
I don't even know. Well, I'm going to do a little piece for y'all tonight called Reflections. Another beautiful day is ending. The sky begins to show off its artistic and glorious views. He has a vision of a flawless sunset. His color ingredients consist of vibrant peach blended with soft creams infused with calming blues. Massive clouds stretched across the never-ending sky, giving the appearance of far-off enchanted floating islands. The air is calm with just a slight breeze to awaken your soul to another fine sunset. This breeze, oh, what a tease it is as it plays and zips within the earth's atmosphere. The sun declines at the great horizon as the moon arises to the same. They respectfully nod at one another, the same as pleasant people do when they pass each other. These wondrous wonders have been friends for such a long time and never have time to chat because of their conflicting schedules. Good night, moon. Good morning, sun. The night, mysterious, sexy, unilluminated, with the exception of the city lights and the stars which twinkle and wink in the sky, flirting with lovers that appreciate such a dynamic show. The moon beams its ecru-colored light in the thick darkness of the indigo sky. Its effects begins to pour a relaxing sleeping potion upon us because it knows about the extensive day we've all had. This is the time for us to be freed from stressed minds, and tis the time to be released of the tension within our bodies from the long day that has passed. Our bodies fall limp. We have no choice but to give in to the night's potion. Potent, isn't it? Hours pass once again, and the moon shift has ended. It slowly declines from the sky into the great horizon as the sun begins to arise to the same. Another day has begun, and they speak in passing. Good morning, sun. Good night, moon. And eat, butterfly, lady scorpion.
Wow, that was beautiful, sis.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Scorpion, that's what you do. Come on with that work. Give them that work. The work. 24-hour lockdown. Give them that work. Memphis style. Then gangster walk on them. Tell them about a gangster walk. They don't even know about a gangster walk. Yeah, gangster walk on them.
Don't do it. I wrote that about 4 years ago. So, one of my
4 years ago, Rip? Wow.
Yeah, that's about 4 years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You need a CD.
You think I could do that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you and Panther, y'all need to get a CD going. Y'all need to get on stage. Y'all need to get on the move.
I got to get a studio somewhere.
Oh, yeah. I got a surprise for you. Damn.
Uh-oh.
I got a schedule for you, and you.
Oh, really?
Oh, shit.
I know right now.
No, this was going to happen.
Uh-huh.
It was an idea that y'all put together, that y'all was talking about. But I want a triple collab. I need a triple collab between you three. It's never been done.
Okay.
That's very true. We've never done.
True. Yeah.
And it's the bonus round. Once you get that triple collab together, we're going to record it, and that's going to be a track on the album. Boom. Y'all can call it what you want to call it.
Mm. All right. Sounds good. I would love to do a collab with my sisters. Most definitely.
I had a dream. And when I dreamed, I was in the honey pot, right? When I was in the honey pot, I was like, they need to do a collab together. And then I saw y'all in y'all outfits representing y'all individual cities with y'all style and y'all grace. And then, you know, Daddy's Girls, the upgrades version. And then you slide the honey bee in the mix of that. That's some crazy shit. Still be like, what was that? Who was that? Is that Tigress? No, that's Savage. Oh, that's Savage Tigress? Oh, look at this. Like, that's Black Lives and Punk. How you feel about that shit? They all be like, is that Butterfly? No, that's motherfucking Scorpion. No, that's motherfucking Serena. What? Same with your chest. Bam! I said, this shit gonna be crazy.
Well, I would be more than honored to do a collab with y'all ladies. You know that. You already know it.
Oh, definitely. Be an honor.
Yeah.
It's going to be hot. I'm going to be like y'all biggest fan / groupie / promoter / I'm going to do all that same time. I'm putting it everywhere. I'm tagging everybody. I'm telling people on the radio right now, when this stuff come out and it's hot, I don't care if we're not friends. I don't care if you're in Zimbabwe. You will be tagged with their piece. Holler at your boy.
He's 7 minutes, Yuri. Holla at your boy. I got that.
It's not even written yet.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, all right, family. I'm going to lay back in the cut, let y'all do your thing. Love y'all very much.
Love you too, sis.
Love you too.
Okay.
All right.
Well, since we don't have that many callers tonight, we may just go back around. But I do have a piece. I think I had posted it, but I added to it. It doesn't really have a title. Okay. Yeah, there?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I don't know. I'll be quiet.
I thought she was about to bust out in poetry, so I was hushed.
All right. I haven't read this over, but I'm going to go for it anyway. I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Daily, I'm forced to converse amongst wolves that breed from the need to deceive me. Yet, thou art with me. I hold back the tears, step out without fear. Yet, they vomit dirt from past hurt. They abuse my name for their own fame. There's something about that name. Yet, thou art with me. Why should I run to the church, fill the plate with tokens? When I leave, my heart is still broken. Yes, I heard the word that is spoken. When that I am is instilled in me from a young age, yet thou art with me. I can get on bended knee. Lord, are you hearing me? These demons don't know me. They see a soul that's set free from misery. They see that he abides in me. They want to retain me. They can't have me, for thou art with me. As I wrestle with earthly flesh, blindsided by demons, they come in right and left, for thou art with me. When my own reflection sends my mind in a state of depression, when an enemy appeared to be a friend, where were you then? I suddenly felt an uplift. You carried my load before my steps could even shift, for thou art with me. What greater gift you gave to me? Who else would sacrifice such a seed? That's true love. Deeper than I've ever seen. It's enough for me to believe thou art with me and eat.
I love that piece. I love your delivery. Your delivery is getting so much more like smooth and just, I love it.
Thank you.
That was divine. In this piece, the reason why her delivery is smooth, I'm going to tell y'all the ancient Chinese pterodactyl secret about her delivery. What people don't know is when she deliver her pieces, she crosses her legs, right leg on the left. She puts her hand slightly on her hip to the left. Then she swings her hair like a Head and Shoulders commercial. Then she was like, I'm about to spit this shit out this piece. Watch this. Then she don't even bat an eye. So she be like, I'm this beast. Today do I walk through the valley shadow of death. Like she has that machismo that oozes from her pores. Like, you already know I got the juice. I can't even see you arguing with nobody. Do you know who I am? You wanna argue with me? I ain't even got time for all that.
You is a mess.
Oh my God. Really?
I can see you like, that's so irrelevant. Why are you even talking to me? I should be charging you for wasting my time. I'm fine.
Oh. Thank you for it. I think that was a compliment.
Oh, it is. I can actually see you spitting your pieces, and your pieces like, you know how Luther and some singers can sing and just like barely open their mouth and just can sing? Mm-hmm. Your smoothness isn't a degree because you have a smooth personality in general. So I could see you walking into a room with a dress on, cutting your eye at the crowd like, yeah, I'm sexy. You ain't even got to say it, I know. So before they try to give you them compliments, you already wrote them down in your Palm Pilot. Like, okay, he about to say I'm sexy. He about to say I look good. She's jealous. Oh, she want me. I don't swing that way. I'm strictly.
Good Lord. Oh, you are too much. All right, since you got all these compliments to say, it's time for you to turn it up and blaze this mic up.
Oh, you wanted to turn up?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Do you remember? I ain't gonna say that. Do you understand that you are powerful, lovely, beautiful, from every hair follicle to all of your cuticles? Do you really understand what type of woman you are? Do you understand that you're not just the planets, you're the constellations of the galaxy and everything in the stars by far? Do you realize how powerful you are? I'm asking you this question because I think that because some people don't understand that there's beauty on the inside of you that evolves on the outside of you. It's all these little bitty hypocritical bullshit-ass words that they like to talk to when they're talking with you. Sister. Do you mind if I call you sister for a second, for a moment, for a blink of this eye? I know that you've been raised to be proud until the day that you die, but I want that thing that you was raised to be fruitful and multiply. So there's a couple of words I'm about to say to you that are truth and no lie. You were born from greatness. Ever since the towers of Pisa was created, ever since the Giza pyramid was created, ever since everything on the fucking planet was created, you were here for the main purpose for everything to be elevated. So, sister, can I talk to you for a minute? Don't let not a single solitary person try to co-sign and define the way that you was made or you was created. And don't let they slick talk be slick talk only when they're inebriated, sister. Because regardless if the world likes you or not, you are already a celestial being. So from the bottom to the top, you were born and blessed to be the cream of the crop. So when you walk the streets, you open up shop. And I'm going to tell you, my sister, you will have jealousy in every single degree. Every other nationality will be jealous of thee because you have something that they don't have that moment. And you shine in that moment. But the thing that you got to fight the most is you in the mirror because that's your main opponent. Because you are valuable. I'm not just saying this because I'm a king and I can look into the eyes of a queen. I'm not trying to say nothing to all your game plan or trying to fulfill any type of dream. I'm just trying to tell you what I'm being seen. I'm seeing a lot of sisters just like you. People getting degraded and disregarded and being in black, purple, and blue. I've seen a lot of men saying a lot of things that's just not true. But I've seen a lot of sisters saying a lot of things that are just not true. So, sister, let me have these words that are not going to de-evolve you. I want these words to come from my lips like a ever-flowing fountain to evolve you, see, sister. When I say your name with pride. And I say it with truth and strength, not just to coincide. I don't want that makeup or Maybelline to get into your skin and turn your skin to have a mental homicide because everything that's in them chemicals is just slowly tiptoe ways for you to die. But I don't want you to die. I want you to give a new birth because you are the rebirth up in this new earth. I want you not just to be the surfboard. I want you to be the tidal wave, going all across, showing them that you are from the land of the home of the brave. And I don't want you to be shackled down by anything. You have never been a slave, see, sister. I'm just a humble man with a humble plan, so I'm giving you this humble pie. I'm telling you that you're important. Without you on this planet, most men would die, sister. So whenever you feel down in the dumps, like you play the spade game and you have no trumps, I want you to listen back to this, sister. I want you to remember these words, sister. Your feet should be rubbed. Even if you don't like your feet being rubbed, they should still be rubbed, my sister. Your bathtub should be made if you got a man that really loves you, my sister. is way beyond just material things. Men that have adorned with the eyesight of God can understand when they're looking into the eyesight of Queen, my sister. So then let nobody disrespect you, my sister. And you ain't got to come off cocky, but yes, you might have to check a couple of them, my sister. But you, my sister, I want you to know you, my sister. Not in my blood time type view, but I mean in a spiritual sense, because even when I was born to protect you, my sister. So if no man ever told you this in your life, not even your first man that was ever in your life, if your father never said this to you, I'm going to say it tonight. I love you, my sister. And you.
I'm showing off.
I know, that was powerful piece. Showing the sister some love. Yeah, he did. He done came back acting all brand new. In a good way, though. In a good way, but yeah.
I evolved. Thank you, Queenie. But I evolved. This is a metamorphosis.
Don't be using that word. That word, is I took it off the dictionary.
Metamorphosis?
Metamorphosis is my word.
Look here. All right, well, I'm going to let you have your word. Well, I've been so supercalifragilistic before it was ever allodocious.
You can hear that. Perception and metamorphosis is mine. You can have all the rest of them words.
Perception?
Hmm?
So you said perception is a word?
No, perception. I got that word in like 35,000 of my poems. That's my favorite word ever. That and irrelevant.
I got you. I got some words for you. They're going to be your favorite words at the end of this show.
Okay.
Oh, no. I don't discriminate. You got some words coming for you, too.
Oh, I do? Oh, okay.
They powerful words. They're going to uplift you. You're going to look at 50 Shades of Grey in a whole different way. But let me flip it back for the way that Patrick will understand. You're going to see 50 Shades of Purple when I get finished.
That's fucked up. Why are you using my stuff?
Oh, man. All right, yeah, we're going to take a quick music break. Anybody that's in the call queue, I mean, if you want to get in the call queue, hit *6. And we'll be back in a few minutes, and we're going to continue this open mic.
All righty.
Back to life, back to reality, back to life, back to reality.
Oh,
Welcome back, everyone. We are back on HDR Live. Miss Panther in the building, Mr. Beast King. We also have a little guy roaming around the building.
Damn, supposed to keep on biting me. Coyote must be here.
What's going on, everybody? This is John Holt, a.k.a. Beast King Coyote. You know, the man with the sleeves all flying around, all you see like that, ready to attack you, because it's Tuesday. Let's do this. I'm here. Quit playing with my microphone, Miss Tigers. We can do this. It's too hot outside. It's hot. It's hot.
You're all wet and dragging and fleas. Can you stand over there?
Huh? No, what?
Can you stand over there?
Way over here? Right here?
No, over there.
All the way over there? Seriously? Jeez. The last time you put me over there, you know what I'm saying? Y'all done shut off the lights, locked the doors and everything like that, and just left me there all week. I get scared in the dark. I get scared.
We left you some water. Stop complaining, selfish.
Oh, yeah. Today is Tuesday. It's Doomsday for the Tag Team Hall of Fame. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to forewarn everybody. Today is you got zero. Wait, you said Mr. Rumble here? No, okay. Mm-hmm. So what I was trying to say is, hey, family, how y'all doing? I'm not no fool.
Yeah, you're about to get it.
I'm not no fool.
So how are you tonight?
Okay, anybody that's listening right now, I want to let y'all guys know that sounds very nice and pleasant, but that's a setup. Let's see how this plays out, because I just do that. I'm all right. How you doing?
I'm good. What's wrong with asking you how are you doing? Glad you could join us tonight. Are you getting nervous?
I don't trust you. And where is Mr. Rumble at? I'm just saying. Well, sitting around here, so you next thing I know, I'm gonna have somebody lifting me up by my shirt, breathing down my neck, talking about what you're doing. I ain't doing nothing. Just set up. And then 901 gonna be looking at my through my window. Nah.
Oh, really?
I'm cool. I ain't scared.
You ain't scared of 901?
Huh?
You ain't scared of 901?
And I said, huh?
I heard my damn name.
Where did you come from?
Oh, I'm always around. Don't you worry about that.
No. What I was trying to... No, listen. Okay, listen. All right. So, what I was... hey, brother, how you doing? Listen,
She doing
okay.
Fine. Butter is doing fine. You ain't talking to Butter. This lady Scorpion 901 right now. Scorpion the one looking through your window.
Anybody that's listening right now,
what?
Remember, it's SaveCoyote.com. Y'all know that funeral that I think of? No, I never said that nobody was going to have a funeral but me. Look, they was going to make a funeral, and I came on. This is fucked up.
Keep on.
It is.
Oh. I'm going to be back in the cut. Mention that on one hand.
My phone has been muted. That's a scary
thing. Back. I'm going to be sitting back in the cut watching your ass. You just know this.
Thank you. Where the fuck did you come from?
The bag.
Can I ask you a question? You've been looking through my window for 6 fucking months. I have not been able to leave my damn house. Where can I get some?
Ain't no
I've been in your house. You need to clean up your room. You know, I've been over you while you sleep, right?
You need to my house?
You need to clean up your damn room. I'm tired of stepping on shit when I walk through the door as I stand over you watching you as you sleep.
So when I woke up at 4 o'clock in the morning the other day, I felt something. That was you, wasn't it? Where did you go when I opened up my... I don't want to know.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't ask no questions. Don't ask no questions, y'all.
I want to say for the duration of this show, I would refuse to ask anybody at all any questions. There will be no questions being asked by me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm, do you. But you got to watch yourself. Watch yourself, y'all.
Love you too.
Love y'all.
Love you.
Oh, wow. You hitting some high notes there, bro.
Trying to get my melody on. See, I was letting y'all have fun. I told the bodyguards they didn't have to come to the show today because, you know, I bought y'all guns, so he don't want those problems.
Oh, I got warrants. You can't be telling people I got a gun.
No, you can't be telling people you got warrants. Get it correct.
Oh. So, Little Beast King.
I was just trying to dip over in my home business. You know what I'm saying?
Did you really just try to slip off like we was going to forget? No.
Mm-hmm. No. No, look. When she said that she was standing over me when I was asleep, I shut the fuck up real quick. Shit got real. I felt something breathing on me the other day. I don't know what the fuck it was, and I opened my eyes and just disappeared and was gone. That shit is scary. I'm not fucking with no 901, no. No. What the fuck did I just walk into? I didn't even know. Hey, Mr. Rondo. You
again.
Said nobody go.
You said 901 again. I'm just sitting here on my own business. You keep on wanting to bring 901.
He didn't even call you by his by your name. He called you 901, so now you're just a number.
What?
I'm just a number.
She's just a number?
Oh, right.
Not even a number, an area code.
She's an area code? Is that how we doing these things? We about to get uncivilized. We about to get uncivilized, Coyote, in this piece.
Oh, when these people out the way, it's about to get messy in here.
Come on, everybody! It's SaveCoyote.com. Keep the hope alive. I'm not gonna make it. What time is it? Oh my God!
Oh, we got plenty of time.
It's time for me to pull out my black ninja outfit and come up there and whoop some ass. That's what time it is.
Please.
Let me get my black ninja outfit out.
Miss King Coyote.
Uh huh.
Miss King Coyote. Don't make me say your name all these times.
Oh, okay, all right. I'm not. Yeah, I'm fucked
he
up
was
right now.
You was refusing to answer. Ooh,
oh,
bad.
Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no, no. No, 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 no. No, my mic was muted.
But we hear you, though.
No, somebody's mic was muted, and I was trying to fix it at the time.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. So she's just the area code now, huh?
I'm just the area code. Really? Really?
I think you're going to need to correct that before we play 52 pickup or 32 pickup. Yeah. Whatever comes first.
Late. It's too late.
Oh, okay.
It's too late.
All right, we're gonna do it old school, Scorpion.
Mm-hmm.
You ready? This is what we're going to do. We're going to flip a coin. Heads, we beat them up. Tails, we beat them up.
This does not work out in my favor.
Let me flip the coin.
What? Do y'all know I'm standing right here? Can you see? Hello? Anybody? Nobody cares? I just don't just laugh. Okay.
Mm-hmm. No, Coyote,
yeah,
I have your back.
I want to try out. Thank you.
I have your back, Coyote. I am Bartholomew J. Esquire, and I will be her lawyer for today. I'm sorry, I can't be. It's a Scorpion. I can't be have your back. I'm sorry. But since I'm her lawyer, in the literary association of what she pays me to do, if. Pre-porn quote, if you do not say her name instead of this area code, we will take fingertips, bones, eye sockets, nose, back, spinal column, intestines. We're going to have.
Scorpion. I don't want to say the number, but y'all know that number. They got the one and that six right next to it. And I know. Right? I'm not no fool. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I'm her lawyer, and she pays me in poetry. So you in trouble? You in trouble?
Oh no!
Hold on, I'm on your side, but because she pays me in poetry, I'm not on your side now.
Oh, shit.
Mm. Hey, how they go? You see how they go, right? I'm sorry, wait till you go to sleep tonight. I'll be waiting.
I just said I won't go.
Make sure the house is nice and dark. Make sure to have it nice and dark on the inside. Yes, yes.
And then y'all wonder why I'm afraid of the dark.
Gotcha. All right, y'all. I'm gonna sit back in the cut again, and let me hear some more mess come out your mouth, y'all.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to cut your tail off and stick it in my back pocket like Huckleberry Finn. You hear me? Going to be my souvenir. Right.
I just like the way everybody just stops and just listen. Like, y'all just going to watch her destroy me and just laugh and high five each other. Like, good job, sis. I mean, damn, it's
And I holler at y'all. Just let me know if you need me.
All right.
Okay.
Well, Coyote, with all that being said, do you have a piece for us?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
All right, mic is yours.
All right. The word nigga. You see, in this modern day world, we seem to consume the word of hate, the slave word for doom. This word has been drenched in red from our blood. It enslaved us like swine, chained and dragged us through the mud. How fast we've forgotten those lynch mobs and scars, the burying and beating of those hot brands and bars. We were hunted like prey and sold on the block. We was branded and bound with chains, braced and locked. Our freedom was taken and humanity stole. We were that night without body or soul. In the belly of the ship, we were chained to its base. We were stacked to a tight column, lying deep and foul that was waste. This word nigga, filled with hate, was all that we see. We were no longer human, just beasts who weren't free. Black women was raped, so men was castrated. Black children was sold, our race was degraded. We were bred just like cattle to make slaves out of slaves. We was forced into labor and forced into our grave. With the crack of a whip, the word was yelled out. With each break in our neck, the rope showed no doubt. Niggas was used to take guilt out of our blame, because it made us humane to kill with no shame. Yet after all these years of torment and pain, this word, this use of this word was weakened our brain. We throw it around like a word with no past, though its history lies for the shadow of cast. It's not part of our language in every sentence we say. It shows off our ignorance in a sorry, sad way. My nigga, there's no culture, though it's no other culture, no other race that will embrace such a slur. We welcome disgrace. Yet we as black people have done so much over the years, with our dignity lost and no heart with no tears. It's part of the reason we will never excel the slum life of a slaverish hell. We lost all respect and we lost our pride. We've forgotten all those tears from those that have died. And yet, we still use this word on ourselves when it means nothing but a servant in hell. So, my nigga, you see, change that means you can change the meaning, you can change the word. But one thing you can't change is how our ancestors cried, lied, and died just to help you beautify what lies between your eyes. This is John Hall, Peace King Coyote, Hungry.
That was magnificent.
Yes, that. I am very surprised you really stepped your ink up in that piece. I'm going to be nice to you for 5 minutes, maybe 5 minutes or less. But that was a real powerful piece. Wow. Okay.
Thank you, ladies.
You're welcome. Where's Shark Bait at?
Oh, well.
He stepped out for a minute, but I'm here. Mr. Coyote.
Yes, sir.
That piece we're going to have to discuss. What inspired you on that piece?
Somebody earlier told me to step my game up.
Oh, so the other individual earlier inspired you to step up?
I really appreciate that, stepping up. That was very impressive. You want to hear the good news or the bad news?
Go for it. Both.
Good news is you've impressed the higher ups with your ingenuity and your wordplay. Now, the bad news is that if you ever go under what you just did, if you ever go backwards, I'm going to break both of your legs. And I'm going to put both of your legs where your ears are supposed to be.
Damn.
Wow.
My leg does not bend that far. Wait a minute. I got tail being cut off. My leg being folded in ways that it can't be folded and shit. And just some real life stuff. Real.
And because of what you've done on that particular piece, you just got you as a bonus from you being so good at that. You just got an extra 20 assignments.
Yes.
That's a hell of a bonus.
I'm gonna get to tell you your assignments live first time. You have to have five pieces that describe five body parts on your body, and you talk from not you, but from their interpretation of the world around them.
I gotta go on mute, sorry.
I'm not going on mute.
You have five pieces. Before I say this other five, how many languages do you speak?
One. I only speak one.
I'm glad you said that.
No, wait.
You have two pieces. Two out of those five pieces will be in different languages. The easiest languages for you to write, those pieces will be there. So you're going to have to be ambidextrous mentally because you're going to have to learn two languages just to do these pieces.
Okay.
The other three, you're going to have to talk about your five senses and what the world around you, what stories the world around you tells through your five senses. That's the first 10. I know you got it. I ain't worried about it. Your next five after that, you have to work on your not delivery per se, but you have to work on your, you have to spit pieces in front of people that don't know that you do poetry and actually legitimize their commentary about how they felt about your pieces.
You want me to spit my poem in front of people that's never heard it?
Yes.
Okay.
So what I'm saying is you have five pieces for you in your own city for you to create an open mic where there's not an open mic, meaning that if you're at an establishment, a cookout, anything of that nature, that's going to be your open mic. That's going to be your feature. And they have to give you 100% real critique on how they felt about your piece. There's no memorization involved, so you can use paper, phone, whatever it may be on that. Now your last five, You have to create five full-fledged songs. Get the music together and apply your poetry to the music along with being able to perform it. All on two on Honey Drip Radio, three on Honey Drip Radio, and two on Beast Queen Sanctuary. And you will be, when you do this, it's going to be like it's your feature, but it's not your feature. Because I'm going to invite 50 people that you've never seen in your life to these shows just to hear you spit. If we're stepping your game up, we're stepping your game up past clouds. So if you ever spit a piece from this day forth that goes backwards, I'm breaking your legs.
Okay,
I'm out of teacher mode now.
Yep.
You did well.
I was writing it down.
Okay.
Thanks for the assignment, guys.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I leave you out? You know,
nope.
I don't like to leave you out.
You did well with him. He got this.
Yeah, but guess who's his teacher? So guess who got to sit there and make sure he does it?
Oh,
I know. You have an assignment on top of that assignment just because you're beautiful.
Don't make me sit you on top of something because you know you can't get down right.
Don't let me sit you on something. You don't think you in a spin cycle. Don't play with me. Now,
I don't got time for your foolishness.
Actually, you know, 50 assignments sound real good.
You know what, Tigress, didn't you want me to read a piece?
Oh. Yes.
Yes. Please let her read this piece.
This is not my
cut off these 50 assignments. Oh, you still talk? Okay.
I'm not scared of you or your punishments. Anyway. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
All right, this piece is entitled. Maybe you guys can help me title it when I'm finished. How about that, shark bait, instead of, you know, throwing assignments all around? Won't you help me name this piece? Is he ignoring me?
Yep.
Okay. I see. Here we go. There's a difference between being in love and in lust. Trust and believe me, I know, because my heart aches when I'm not with you. Time slows to a crawl as crescent tears fall adjacent to my fears just because I miss you. I can say quietly to myself that I love you, but why should I hide the light within that you set ablaze? I thought at first that this thing was a phase to be expunged, numb to this feeling outside of my children and friends that had become blood. I already knew the first time I held you, there was no turning back. I tried to push you away, expecting the worst, yet you pull me in, loving me, even when loving myself wasn't so easy. You've pleased more than my spirit, boy, can't you feel it? Every time I touch you, I never want to hurt you. Yet times I overthink the small things you do, because a part of my essence now belongs to you. And I doubt my own reflection trapped in your past and says, hey, it was fun. But I guess I don't deserve someone who has my soul cuffed and loosely sealed in both hands. Yet at first, I was in lust with your touch, lips, to your spirit, your intellect, and how deep you gazed into my soul. So fucking bold you have become, sprung off this. This hate filled with a shot of evolution. No, it's you, love. It was deeply rooted, yet tampered with. The way you spit, how you sit in the center of the storm and dodged every hit. Now, I just want to settle at the base, caressing your neck, and put all your fears to rest, because I'm here to show you how to treat a man from deep within. You say, friend, tomato, tomato, you will be the husband I seek, for there's so much more to you than the blind eye can see. Created perfectly for me. To be continued, Panther, Team Hungry, and Eat.
Yes. I remember you posted that one. Yes, I need to hear that one. Love that.
Yeah, it's mushy. Thank you.
Oh, look, Cody, quiet now.
I don't know if I'm allowed to give a response to that because you still got butterflies in the background, and I don't know if I got damn, did I just say her name? Shit.
Do I need to tell her about your 70 licks that you still owe? You better respond, boy.
Ooh. You haven't told me that way. Did y'all see? You see my man? I looked at like, wait, what?
I'm just saying, it's September 1st. That was August 17th.
What just happened there?
Just like a bank, that means gain some interest on that. So I'm just saying.
So now it's 140.
The hell just happened? I think that piece was amazing. That, yeah, I'm going old school tonight. Fuck that shit. Hell no. Scared tonight. Like, what the hell is going on around here? What am I, coyote bait going on? Shit, y'all just have me dangling in front of the water while I start just ready to maul my ass. Like, bring them here. More assignments. don't mention the assignment. That was not smart. I didn't do that.
That's what you said.
This is shit got real. Wait a minute. Today's Tuesday, ain't it? Yeah, it is. Okay, just checking. I'm barely hanging on. Okay.
Yep.
DaveCoyote.com. Close. Why? Let me. She just did a form. How did it get on me? Yeah, can I? Yeah.
Oh, well, we seem to have lost Mr. Beast King and Serena, but even though I could have told you that, Cody, before you tortured yourself, but I wanted to wait. My bad. Oops.
I love y'all for a day.
Alright, you know what I'm saying? Tag Team Hall of Fame on Tuesday. Okay, I got to do. All right.
Oh boy. Yes. It's been a fun show tonight, hasn't it, Cody?
I'm still not asking no questions. I didn't give a shit. I'm not saying a damn thing. I know what you're talking about. Shit. I got assignments to do with this shit.
Oh, yeah, you do, you do. Well, we'll bump in a few minutes, so you'll have plenty of time to get a few done tonight, you know. You got a lot to do.
I got, ladies, well, hell, I'm kind of afraid to read this now. Yeah, I got a poem I would like to do, if you don't mind, and get your guys' opinion that I was writing, like, right before the show.
Okay.
No, the way this night been going, I need for somebody to say, oh, you good, you can go ahead, something, you know what I'm saying, just push me out there. Hand me them. I don't know, I'm not doing
you, shit. You're good, you can go ahead. You got
and
okay.
Pastor, is that okay with you? Is that all right with you? Nah, I need to get clarification.
Perfectly fine.
I just wanted that documented so that when we go to my funeral, all of us, I'll be there.
That's a show. Yeah, you asking me for.
I look out my window and see the glowing lights of my city. I wonder. And I gaze up at the night skies and yes, it is quite pretty. Wondering to myself, daydreaming about the finer things in life. And I think, what's really the point? I mean, there's the city with its beautiful light, but the people inside think I'm going to be stuck here for the rest of my life. I refuse. As a black male, they try to trap us in what we call, in what they call a ghetto life. I'm going to choose, but I wonder. As I'm walking through the streets, I pass the cops as they front, just because simple-minded children have to pull that act that's my age with no hope in life. Do they see the same in me? I wonder. If I wear a business suit, will they frown on me? I wonder. Do money make people not care about race? Do a business suit change the color of my face? I wonder. Do anyone know how much I rep my city? But as I'm wondering, is this really my place? You see, we live in a society where people wonder what hood you're from, what color you wear, what job you got, what do you do, who do you know, and what can they get from you? But the question should be, who are you as a human being? As I wonder, this is John Hall, East King Coyote, and hungry.
That was a hot piece right there.
Wow. You really have stepped your game up tonight.
Mm-hmm.
You can
make
you perfectly for
comfort.
Talk about a
girl with benefits. Love, Dude, y'all can't be doing that shit. I'm on a heart monitor and everything. Wait a minute. Someone had challenged me today, and they said to me that I need to set my game up higher than I ever been. And I had sat back and thought about it, like, okay, well, let's do this. Team Hungry style.
Wow.
Well,
big Beast King, what do you think of this? Maybe he needs a few more assignments.
No, I'm not going to put nothing more than he can bear. Them 20 assignments he just got is going to wear him out anyway.
Yeah,
but
that's
gonna,
true.
So when he comes with, it's going to be ridiculous.
Yes, wow, he's just showing out tonight. So basically, mm-hmm. he's saying that he's been slacking all this time. He hasn't been giving us his all.
Really?
I'm just putting it out there like that. That's my interpretation. But
is that how you doing this? I ain't did nothing. Okay, all right, okay.
I just made a statement. That's all I'm just saying.
I got you. 3 o'clock. Me and you out there in Plainfield. Let's do this. Tomorrow, when the weather drops, it's hot right now. I can't do this. It's too hot. Black people shouldn't be in the sun. I'm just saying.
You threatening my sister?
Huh?
Threatening my sister? Yeah.
No. What I was saying that we was fuck. We was gonna have, you know, barbecue, you know what I'm saying, had the kids over and everything, you know, and water fights and, you know, mm-hmm. all kinds of crazy.
You can tell he always was in trouble when he was little. He come up with shit on point.
He do. He just have it ready. What happened was a lot, didn't you?
Thank you,
oh,
Mr. Rambo.
Boy.
Oh,
my goodness gracious.
People looking, standing over my shoulders and shit. He can't find me. Yeah, you get good. Wait a minute.
All right, we got one more caller to take before we get ready to close out of here. 651. Welcome.
Hey, peoples.
Hey,
hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you? This is Pheromones.
Hello, Slave Bay.
Yeah. Man, what's wrong with Coyote?
I'm trying to answer you and give you big hugs, but they keep grabbing my damn tail. I'm trying to use my arms out and everything.
Hey, I'm gonna need you to put some big voice. What is wrong with you?
I know,
I'm just
right?
trying.
Shit.
Is that my, who was that? Who that? Who that?
Oh,
that's my
face? I just squealed like that.
Oh,
hey, bro.
I got a surprise for you, Faye.
What? I love surprises.
I'm coming to see you, Faye, after I come see Panther.
Oh, okay. All right.
What'd you come to see me? When hell freezes over?
No.
Girl,
but
a snowball fight in hell.
No. I actually, because I go on the Megabus, and the Megabus goes to Minnesota.
Yeah, it sure does.
And I didn't know that, so when I saw it, I said self, and self was like, well, how can I get to my little sister? So I looked, and I know how to get to you now. But you should have been with me this weekend anyway in Chicago.
I didn't know what was going on with the, I didn't know who, what, where, when. I saw it being advertised, but I didn't understand what was going on or Maybe, you know, my mind was just drifting off. I don't know.
You didn't see me?
Didn't see you where?
I perform live on World Warrior Show.
Where is the for the whole thing?
I posted it like crazy. It's Oxygen. They posted Oxygen. I met Oxygen, KB, the Queen, Brother O, World Warrior, Alien, Brother Amir, Hood Rays. We was all there. If you look at World Warrior's profile picture, it's me and him.
Okay, well, I got to go to his page because he's on his page.
Yeah, now, you know, you know your bro. My little sessions I did, my little something, I posted on my wall and a lot of other people's walls. But since you didn't see it, that means I got to go to your wall, too.
Whatever. I always think the family always come last.
No.
I'm not
even going to say that. I give you the whole sandwich. I don't give you half the sandwich. You eat the sandwich,
not
eat the fire.
Honey.
I just eat a piece of the cornbread. You get the cornbread and the greens and the macaroni cheese. Yeah. You get the whole meal. I just eat a half of a section of the cornbread.
We going over Pants' house? Because I be seeing her cook stuff like that.
Come on.
She ain't ready for all of us to come over there. She don't have no food.
I cook for 10 people every day.
10? Wow.
I'm 10 people in one.
I'm
going to
put mine
so
in.
That's 20.
I want some black-eyed peas and rice.
Get em.
I want some greens. I want some cornbread. I want some sweet potatoes. And I want some, what do I want? What kind of meat?
Cheesecake. I'm just, okay.
Yeah, but you can add that. Yeah, get a coyote some cheesecake and some southern fried chicken and gravy. Yeah.
All right, got you.
Hook it up.
I like the way she named food and shit. Hell yeah. My stomach started growling right there when we cooking this. Can we have that tomorrow?
You ain't coming through. I got to cook. I got to buy a fucking $300 worth of food.
Well, you said you cook for 10 people. What's 10
more? Hey, we can all chip in and send in for the food. You know?
Mm-hmm.
I like
I got $5
like
on it.
That's why
you got $5 on it,
really?
Y'all gotta taste. I know I might be the only African American that does this, but I do not like cornbread. I don't even like bread.
Yeah,
what?
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm not listening to you right now. That was an alien talking. Alien talking.
No, because my mom used to make me eat stacks of bread when I was little, and I just don't like bread. It's her fault. I mean, stacks of bread, like 6 breads per plate. And I used to, like, bury it in the dirt and give it to my baby brother type. Yeah. I hate bread.
Wow.
Damn,
why
so much bread?
I don't know. That's to get me full. I hate bread, and it's all her fault. I don't like stuffing, and I don't like cornbread. I make it, but I make somebody else taste it because I can't. I can't do it.
What kind of stuff is you on? You're not
I'll
human.
I'll come and make
I'm
a dressing.
Human.
Don't y'all want some dressing? It's about time for dressing.
I mean,
yeah.
I can make it. I just don't eat it. I need somebody to taste it for me while I'm making it.
You're not making nothing that you don't like to eat. So I do the dressing, baby.
I make the Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
I make the Kool-Aid.
No, you stay away from the sugar.
Okay, I wanna share this piece with y'all. Thank you, bro. I just saw you put that on my timeline. It's called The Comforter.
Awesome.
Yeah. It's very sweet and short. It starts off like this. Me not having my strong shoulder. I will rest my weary head and thoughts against the wall of silence, of he who left me naked and afraid. But my soul is not full of anger, because our good times we shared outweigh the bad. Damn, I miss my strong shoulder. The coolness of this wall puts ease to my aching temple, but the shoulder I once rested my head on was warm and tender. Now I'm lonely and I'm afraid. What will happen to me now? Will rest ever find my traveling soul? Will this here wall forever be my comforter? Oh, Lord, please don't let another be resting their head on my strong shoulder. Replace this speechless wall, tear it down, then just maybe, maybe, my warm shoulder will be found behind it. And that's that peace.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was fighting with my mute button. That was a beautiful piece. Love that.
I couldn't get off mute either. I'm on our PC phone. Yes, that was. That was. I love your delivery too, sis. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
Say, say. That was so wonderful. I love me for you. Give me a hug. Bring it in.
Wait a minute. Can I get a hug?
No, you can't get a hug. No.
But can you?
That's my sister. Stop it. I slap you. You hug over there.
You said.
I'm just playing. You can hug her now. I'm just playing. You got 10 seconds.
Give me a hug. Come on. Come on.
Okay. Thank you.
That's good hug. Now go sit down.
Oh, yeah. I'm on. Hey, say, I'm so glad to hear your voice, seriously. And
you all too.
And that poem you just did, I like that. And I think a lot of people can feel exactly where you're coming from in so many different ways. So I really appreciate it, just sitting back, just listening to it.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, that, like I tell y'all, a lot of my pieces come from actual lifetime events and just thinking about things and, you know, the places and the times that, you know, was in at that moment, you know, the thoughts that were traveling through my. And that was one of those moments.
Okay.
Yeah, and I sometimes think the simple poetry is the best poetry.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate you coming on tonight and joining us and sharing that with us.
I want y'all to come on my show tomorrow night, me and Sidani. And for real, we got the Love by Candlelight coming back.
Oh, too. I get to put on my good pass.
And it's late night poetry for lovers.
Oh, yeah. I get to bring it.
So you know we're going to get down.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
what time does it start?
It starts it's 12 o'clock you guys' time. You guys are on the East Coast, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
12 o'clock a.m. Tomorrow night. So that I guess that'll be on the 3rd. You know what I'm saying? Because it started late night at 12 a.m.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I'll be there.
So if you don't do anything but just come on and just, you know, if you don't want to spit, you cuddled up in bed or whatever, you know, just come on and just lay back and listen, because I'm going to have some good music. and good conversation and some good love poetry.
For lovers only, for lovers only, only, for lovers only.
I'm coming. I don't get too much love poems, but I'll try to make it.
No, you got some love. You got some love in your loins. It's in your loins. You got it deep on the inside. It's on the inside of your solar plexus. It's not in your abdomen.
You know what? I don't know what I'm gonna do with. I love you, but girl, you be doing me in with the pictures of these men. You be, what the hell do you be thinking about? I get on
you
the
know
computer
what,
late, and I'm like, damn, what is she doing? Me in this empty-ass bed.
Sorry, but you know what, though? If my dude... You know what I'm saying? If I ever get one of those, you know what I'm saying? If he had a nice body, I'd be posting them all over Facebook. They're like, what is wrong with you? Hey, he's mine.
Nobody is. He gangster like that.
I'll let everybody see. I'm using somebody's husband's picture every time I post. Somebody's husband, brother, sister, uncles, cousins, you know, so I put like it.
Yeah, like, I understand. Like, that one dude, that's Junebug and them, that little man in Saudi. His little name is Cleophas.
You keep on talking, I'm going to have you on Facebook.
I want you to. Facebook will never be the same. You want me to go on Facebook? I have no shame in the game. I'll bring Adam and Eve back for real. Play with me. Facebook will be like, what?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, I have no shame at all. I know what God made.
I'm trying to get off of Facebook because you want to be naked.
I don't care about being naked. But I have no shame. I have no say.
Let me ask y'all this. Who is BRPP?
B who?
Black Radio and the Interviewers?
I don't know.
Black Radio? Black Hole Radio?
I don't know who these people are.
I know. Well, the only... Well, I know Black Hole Radio, but that's under... That's under BPC. I know Epiphany's out there. Oh, yeah, that reminds me. I met your sister.
Which one?
In poetry. Born to Write.
No.
Me and her in the picture together.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I love her.
Yeah.
I hate that word, but I just want to put that out there for everybody to know. If you're going to call me your sister, I'm your sister. Do not call me your sister in poetry.
Oh, but okay. Now I got to get off
of
Facebook.
Wait a minute, how did Kimbrella Renee get the, get you 13 hours ago? Wait a minute, let me go to my...
sorry to cut y'all off, but we got to close out because I got to go get my daughter.
Well, somebody needs to go make a talk show.
I don't care. I'll make one right now. All right.
Well, go on and make it. Let's get this.
All right, well, thank y'all for coming on tonight. We'll be back Thursday for Panther Show at 7 p.m.
Okay.
And we will see you then, all right?
All right.
All right.
All right.
Love you, sis.
All right, love you, too.
Yeah, I'm confused.
Give it to me.